The narratives that you are about to see are fictionalized scenarios. Names, characters, businesses, places, events, locales, and incidents are either the products of the author's imagination or used in a fictitious manner. Any resemblance to actual persons, living or dead, is purely coincidental. The Use Case 2 narrative demonstrates in-flight intent changes in a high-density airspace. Now that the UAS operation plans are deconflicted and successfully launched over Rome, there are new challenges to face. Megan, the recreational videographer and influencer, experiences a communications failure and her drone is labeled contingent or rogue, creating risk for other airborne UAS. This state of contingency is communicated to the USS network, alerting other operators nearby. Recognizing the risk, Megan safely lands her drone and works to troubleshoot the problem, while the other operators determine they are clear and continue with their missions. Then, seemingly out of nowhere, a series of powerful wind gusts disrupt the airspace around the inspection drone operated by the Chamber of Commerce over the farmers market, temporarily forcing it out of its operational volume and prompting its USS to flag the drone as non-conforming. This information is transmitted to the USS network, notifying all operators of the interference from the Chamber's UAS flight path. The other operators adjust as needed until the winds die down and the Chamber's drone regains control to continue monitoring the farmers market.
What happens if there are changes that occur in mid-flight of an operation or a UAS? We wanted to make sure we're able to address not only the strategic aspects of pre-flight planning, but also when changes arise while an operation is ongoing. In this use case, those types of interactions take place a little bit more frequently in order to address the challenges as operations are taking place in the same environment. Pulling on that thread of deconfliction and strategies to address deconfliction, if those modifications occur as a UAS is in flight, what are the repercussions that has on both operators, and how are they able to deconflict is one of the key areas that we wanted to explore.
What happens in this particular use case is that we have one aircraft that's flying, a light aircraft that's flying, and we intentionally have it deviate from its known flight plan.
We're actually going to go rogue on UAS 5 contingent.
We simulate an event that some kind of wind happened and it blew this aircraft out of its reserved flight volumes that it has within the USS. It would be marked as non-conforming. We're flying an off-nominal situation that is not conforming to the flight volume that has been submitted for in the USS. USS alerts not only the operator of that aircraft, they alert other aircraft that are flying the area because we're relatively close to the other aircraft, and depending on how far this guy veers off from his normal course, the other operator should be aware of it. So this is utilizing, again, the USS network of communication, the USS that individual operators are using, and they're getting information feedback from this non-conforming flight. So then we tell this aircraft to go back in conformance. And in this particular case, everybody gets alerted saying, oh, don't worry about that aircraft any further because it's back in conformance. Other things that we do in this particular use case is another one, we take a simulation that's flying. And that simulation, we have it go into a contingent state based again on definition of this standard and on how UTM network operates. If they exceed their non-conforming boundary for a period of time, they essentially are considered contingent state. And when you're a contingent state, essentially you're an aircraft that has gone off script for too long and you are expected to just land your aircraft. What we emulate is a lost comm link. The aircraft kind of went stupid and it flew off course. And in this particular case, all we can do from a USS network standpoint is tell the pilot, hey, your aircraft is off course. But the other thing is we tell the other operators in the area, hey, this aircraft is going a little crazy here. We gotta let you guys know about it. And we keep track of it. Other operators, based on where they're located, they can change their operational intent. They can choose to go someplace else. They can choose to go land. In our particular case, we have one of our operators actually land a little early. We turns out that one of our aircraft is kind of low on battery life, and so we have it change its operational intent, and then we have it planned.